Hello students, myself Suresh, welcoming you to this small session. Today topic is structure of nephron, which is the structural and the functional unit of kidney. You know, each kidney is made up of nearly 1.3 to 1.8 millions of microscopic filtering units called nephron. This nephron is also called uriniferous tubule. So in this session we are going to see the structure of nephron. Each nephron shows two main parts. One is Malthusian body and the second one is renal tubule. You can see in this diagram here there is a cup like structure which is called Malthusian body, here to here, and the continuing part of small tubular structure comes under renal tubule. This total together means Malthusian body and renal tubule together forms the nephron, right? The first part is Malthusian body. This Malthusian body contains two parts. One is Bowman's capsule and the glomerulus. Here you can see the Bowman's capsule and glomerulus together making Malthusian body, right? Here the cup shaped structure which is holding the blood capillaries is called Bowman's capsule, right? And this Bowman's capsule is holding the glomerulus. Glomerulus is developed by the afferent arteriole and the efferent arteriole. See here the arrow marks showing you the entry of arteriole into the Bowman's capsule and the exit of arteriole. When this arteriole is entering into the Bowman's capsule, it is forming a network of capillaries and leaving the Bowman's capsule, right? You can observe here, this is incoming, that is afferent arteriole is wider than the efferent arteriole, which is appearing narrow. You see here, this is wider and this is narrow. This is afferent arteriole and this is efferent arteriole. First of all, you have to know what are these arterioles. Generally, when you observe the human excretory system, which is showing kidney, ureter, urinary bladder and urethra, here these two are two blood vessels which are connected to each kidney. See this pink color, light pink color blood vessel, it is artery. This artery is connected to both kidneys. When this is connected with the kidney, it appears a single artery, but after the entry of this artery into the kidney, right, when it enters into the kidney, it divides into many branches called arterioles. Do you know into how many branches it divides? It divides into the number of, equal to the number of nephrons. How many nephrons are there? That many arterioles are formed by the renal artery which is connected to the kidney. Is it clear? Right? Here the arteriole which is entering into the Bowman's capsule is wider than the arteriole which is leaving the Bowman's capsule. That is, afferent arteriole is wider but the efferent arteriole is narrow. Can you guess what is the strategy behind this? Generally, if we observe the water, when the water is coming out of a big pipe, if we connect a small pipe to it, how the water will come out? It will come out with some force, right? So in the same way, here also, the blood, to send more amount of blood into the Bowman's capsule for filtering, here the afferent arteriole is broader, wider. But when it is leaving the Bowman's capsule, because of the narrow outlet, because of the narrow outlet of this efferent arteriole, it exerts some pressure within the Bowman's capsule, due to which the impurities, the unwanted substances, the excess nutrients all will ooze out of this capillary network into the Bowman's capsule. Got it, children? Why? The efferent arteriole is narrow than the afferent arteriole. That is your question. Is it clear now? Right. So because of this efferent arteriole, it exerts some pressure, because of which the pressure filtration done inside the Bowman's capsule. Right. Here, let us discuss the Malpighian body again. Malpighian body contains Bowman's capsule and glomerulus. Bowman's capsule is a cup-shaped structure, cup-like structure, which is holding the network of blood capillaries, which is called glomerulus, in it. Right. So this glomerulus within the Bowman's capsule, it is surrounded by a layer of squamous epithelial cells called podocyte cells. These podocyte cells are lining the Bowman's capsule, right? And they have fine pores between the podocyte cells, and they allow the passage of waste materials from this capillary of glomerulus into the Bowman's capsule. Right? Here you can see clearly, this line of squamous epithelium is podocyte cells. They have pores in between them, and they allow the filtrate which comes out from the capillaries here into the Bowman's capsule. Right? So into the Bowman's capsule, that filtrate is collected and it will go towards the tubular part. Right? So this is about the Malpighian body. And next to the Malpighian body, renal tubule. This renal tubule, it is a tubular part of the nephron. You can see this. Up to now we discussed only this cup like structure, that is Malpighian body, in which glomerulus is present. Glomerulus is formed by the afferent arteriole, and this efferent arteriole is coming out of the Bowman's capsule. Right. So now you have to see this tubular part, starting from the Bowman's capsule to the collecting duct. Right. It is called renal tubule. This renal tubule shows three parts. One is proximal convoluted tubule, and the second part, loop of Henle, and distal convoluted tubule. This proximal convoluted tubule is the first convoluted tubule, which is directly connected to the Bowman's capsule, right? And it continues as a small loop called a loop of Henle, and by loop of Henle connected to the distal convoluted tubule, that is called DCT, right? So that DCT opens into a collecting tube. This collecting tube form pyramids and calyces within the kidney, right? You can see here, if you observe the kidney structure, the bean shaped kidney, you can see like this. You know, already there is a ureter connected to the kidney to collect the urine. So here within the kidney, you can see there is a area called pelvis, from which renal pyramids are attached. Right. So the collecting tube, which is coming from the DCT, is forming renal calyces within this renal pyramid like structure. So you can see, children, here these are appearing like pyramids, no? So these are called renal pyramids, in which renal calyces are formed. All these renal pyramids are joined to the pelvis, and this pelvis opens into ureter, and that ureter collects the urine from the kidney. Right. So that is about tubular part of the kidney, renal tubule. It shows proximal convoluted tubule, loop of Henle, distal convoluted tubule, and these three finally connected to collecting duct, and collecting duct opens, or it makes renal calyces of renal pyramids, which opens into the pelvis, and pelvis sends the urine into the ureter. Right. So this, the entire kidney is made up of many nephrons, and all will involve in the filtering blood Hence, the nephron is considered to be the structural and functional unit of the kidney.